Go on to that final against Preston.
Moore wins the toss. For Preston, Alex Dawson kicks off. Luckily for Preston, left back Jim Smith is first to the ball, and the Northerners look dangerous. That stings the Londoners into retaliation. Inside left, Jeff Hurst is tackled by Tony Singleton. Kelly saves. Again, it's Preston with outside left Doug Holden menacing West Ham. There's no holding Preston, and after 9 minutes, Doug Holden puts the ball in the net. This is the time for West Ham to pull something out of the bag. A good pass finds John Sissons, and it's the equaliser. Back in the game, West Ham try again, but Jeff Hurst's header is well saved. Preston go all out to regain the lead. Standen concedes a corner. Wilson takes the kick. Centre forward Alex Dawson heads a goal. Preston leads 2-1. Bring on the guard man. West Ham kick off. A goal down, remember. It's a safe bet. They've had a pep talk during the interval. Anyway, they lose no time showing the fighting spirit that got them into the final. Outside right, Peter Braybrook is challenged by Jim Smith. Not quite successfully, a corner for West Ham. Braybrook's kick is just what the Hammers ordered. Centre-half Ken Brown is there, not quite on target. Jeff Hurst does better. And yes, sir, Alan Kelly just fails to keep the ball out. That all happened so quickly, let's see just how West Ham scored the equaliser. Obviously time for West Ham to go into a huddle. Another corner for West Ham. And another escape for Preston. This looks like developing into a goal-mouth scramble, which West Ham will do well to survive. Preston centre-forward Alex Dawson finds Standen unbeatable. Jeff Hurst makes ground, then passes to Braybrook. A promising move. We'll follow it in slow motion. And almost in the last seconds of the game, West Ham inside right Ronnie Boyce heads into the net. And this is just how it happened. West Ham's third goal, which won them the cup. Johnny Byrne starts a one-man training session. Bobby Moore, captain of West Ham, captain of England, and at this moment, happy as any man alive, leads his men to receive the trophy and winner's medal. Lord Harwood represents the Queen.